Hello, this is Miss Antriece with Heirs of Legends. Today we have the pleasure and the privilege and the honor to be here with Mr. Tavis Smiley today. How are you?
I'm well, Antriece. How are you?
I am doing pretty good. I want to say that for you, and I know for me, for you to be back in Charlotte again, because you frequent Charlotte quite often with a lot of the work that you do.
We try. I mean, Charlotte's a great city. The Queen City is a beautiful place to hang out. And you know, it's one of those regional hubs. So if you're traveling an event, Charlotte's a good place to come because people from the region can get here. So I've brought technology summits here. I've brought health summits here. Financial literacy summits here. And now this exhibit. So I love Charlotte.
Yes, sir. Now, in regards to the exhibit that's going to be in Charlotte, North Carolina, at the Harvey Gantt African American Cultural Center. How of a pleasure is that for you, for that to be here in Charlotte?
Harvey Gantt is history, the first African-American mayor of this city. Obviously a great architect, is he? So he's a part of Charlotte history and North Carolina history,
right.
Almost elected to the United States Senate,
yes.
In a race against Jesse Helms that you're too young to remember.
A
historic race for the United States Senate in this state. So he's history himself. This exhibit really hasn't traveled to African American institutions because the exhibit is too big to fit into their spaces.
Wow.
This exhibit, when it's all rolled out, is about 25,000 square feet. I think here it can be about 10 or 12,000. So we've got to make some real choices for how to squeeze the best of the exhibit into this space.
Right.
We wanted to come to Charlotte. We obviously wanted to be here during the time of the Democratic Convention. So to whatever extent people appreciate or love Barack Obama as the first African American president,
right.
It's important to understand the backstory that made this moment possible.
Yes.
And this 400-year, 500-year journey that African Americans have been on, with Africans arriving in Jamestown, Virginia in 1619, from those Africans arriving here all the way up through the election of Barack Obama, there's a story that the country really doesn't know, a story that hasn't been told. So this exhibit, America, I Am, tells that story. We're glad to be told.
Of course, I'm going to personally ask you this because my great-grandfather, Louis Armstrong, in regards to artifacts, do you have a certain section set off for music and the impact, the imprint of other African-Americans with the music?
We do, and we've had one of Louis' horns in this exhibit.
Really?
So we move items in and out, but we have Louis Armstrong stuff, we have Stevie Wonder stuff, we have Prince stuff, Michael Jackson, Marvin Gaye, Jimi Hendrix, Aretha Franklin, Luther Vandross, Smokey Robinson, Lucy Collins, James Brown, Ray Charles. I mean, African Americans have made some grand contributions.
Yes, sir.
But there is no America without our music, without our jazz, without Duke and Miles and Train, without Motown. Motown is the soundtrack to people's lives.
Absolutely.
Without Motown, you know, what is America without Motown? So, you know, this exhibit celebrates all the contributions that black people have made in every field of human endeavor, and clearly music is one of those genres.
Yes, sir. Now let me ask you this. Are you yourself within?
No.
Why not? Really? Because
no.
You're such an activist,
no.
Philanthropist. You give back so much, and I personally
no.
know this. So, you know, I wanted to ask you, why aren't you
no.
in that? I noticed that.
No. No.
The answer is no.
Well,
let me ask you this, because at the end of the day, you are making and have made such a huge impact on black America, on America as a whole. So at the end of the day, for you, what do you hope or wish for your lasting legacy or for your imprint on our society to be?
That's a good question. Every one of us is going to leave an imprint. Intentionally or unintentionally,
right.
Deliberately or, you know, not so deliberately.
Right.
I just prefer to try to control my own destiny. I just prefer to try to be at the helm of and in charge of, in control of what that contribution is going to be. And for me, it's really about loving and serving people. You've heard me say before, you can't lead people unless you love people.
Right.
And you can't save people unless you serve people. If you're interested in loving people or trying to help save people, from conditions that they ought not to be forced to live in, poverty and disenfranchisement, politically, socially, economically. If you're gonna do that, then it requires a deep love. So I love people. My whole life has been about serving people. Sometimes folk agree with you, sometimes they disagree with you.
Right.
But ultimately, my motivations have always been, whether it's on television, on radio, through my philanthropy and my foundation, through my books, through my appearances, through my commentary, through this museum exhibit,
yes,
anything, my public speaking, anything and everything that I have or will ever do is really about trying to love and serve people. I love all of humanity, but that starts for me with a particular and unapologetic love for black people.
Yes.
I just love my own people.
Right.
And I want to make sure that I do everything I can to advance the cause of my people. And in this exhibit, it's about celebrating the contributions that my people have made to the country, but not demonizing anybody else, not casting aspersion on anybody else, because we couldn't have done this all by ourselves.
Right, exactly.
But at the same time, by the same token, the country just wouldn't be without our people. And this exhibit celebrates.
And I want to thank you very, very much for your time. Thank you for your efforts in the community. And again, it's just a personal honor to be in front of you again.
The pleasure again is all mine. Thank you, Ms. Antriece.
Again, this has been Ms. Antriece with Heirs of Legends Media. And today we were here with Mr. Tavis Smiley. Do you have any final words?
If you get anywhere near Charlotte between now and the end of the year, come to the Gantt Center and visit America I Am, the African American imprint. It is the biggest, baddest, boldest exhibit ever to tell the story of the African American contribution to the country. So come be a part of history, see it in live and living color, see all these items assembled in one place. It's a great exhibit. Bring the kids. It costs less than going to a movie. And you're going to learn a lot more. You're going to be empowered by the exhibit. You're going to be inspired by the exhibit. It's America I Am, open right now at the Army Gantt Center in Charlotte.